Hello, I'm Rebecca Haddad. I come from Paris in France, and I would like to thank the ICS Scientific Committee for allowing me to present the results of our study on the best tool to predict the outcome of CIC in training in patients with multiple sclerosis. I have nothing to disclose. So you must know that urinary disorders and especially urinary retention are common in patients with multiple sclerosis, and that clean intermittent catheterization is the reference treatment of residual volume in those patients. Outcome of CIC training depends on several patient skills like motor or cognitive function and environmental parameters. Guidelines on CIC recommend to adapt the training to patients' abilities, suggesting the importance to assess cognitive and motor skills, at least. Two validated instruments, the FIM and the pencil and paper test, are used to assess both motor and cognitive abilities in patients with multiple sclerosis. These tools have been found to be associated with the success for learning CIC. However, no study has determined the diagnosis performance of these tools. So the objective of this study was to determine and compare the performance of these tools to predict the outcome of CIC training in patients with multiple sclerosis. All patients with multiple sclerosis attending a neurology department as eligible for CIC were included in this study. Data recorded during the CIC training session included demographic and medical characteristics as well as FIM and PP test scores. The training session was performed by a continence nurse, and the FIM and PP test scores were assessed by an occupational therapist. Success for learning CIC was recorded at the end of the training session and defined as the ability to perform CIC at least two times. The association between FIM and PP test scores and success for learning CIC were assessed in univariate analysis, and diagnostic performances of FIM and PP tests were estimated by calculating sensitivity, specificity, area under the receiver operating characteristics curve, and IUC of these two tests were compared using a two-sided DeLonge test. A total of 100 patients were included with a mean age of 49 years old. 68% of the patients were women, and 44% of the patients had relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis. The median EDSS score was of 6. As you can see here, both FIM and PP test total and subscores were significantly associated with the success of the CIC training session, and 90% of the patients succeed at the end of the training session. Optimal cutoff values were estimated for FIM total score. It was of 101, resulting of a sensitivity of 83% and a specificity of 80%. And PP test total score, the cutoff was of 12 with a sensitivity of 61% and a specificity of 90%. As you can see here, the IUC of ROC curves for FIM and PP test total score was not significantly different. In conclusion, FIM and PP test have the same diagnosis performance for the outcome of CIC training in patients with multiple sclerosis, and the choice between these tools should be guided by the assessor's preference and the time required to perform the assessment. As you can see here, before the COVID outbreak, it took us like 5 minutes to perform the PP test with me and my colleagues from PM&R. And right here you have the FIM instrument, which need a special training to be performed correctly. Thank you.